Hey everyone, it's great to be part of today's event. My name's Gabe Monroy. I'm the Vice President of the Azure Developer Experience Team in Microsoft's Developer Division. Today, we're going to show you how you can use Azure Arc to build cloud-native applications that run anywhere, enabled by a single control plane and the ability to bring Azure services to any infrastructure. Now, we know the future will be defined by accelerated innovation. We also know that much of this innovation will be digital and will take the form of new applications. Over the last year, the technology industry has been called upon to support those on the front lines, from healthcare and education to public sector, manufacturing, and retail. It's inspiring to see how developers are core to this transformation, going above and beyond to innovate and help reimagine the world. It's increasingly clear that developers are strategic to every business and are central to the next generation of digital products in every industry. Now, one story that comes to mind is Zeiss, an international leader in optics and optoelectronics technology. Now, like many companies, Zeiss is a mix of applications. Some are modernized monolithic apps, some are PaaS services, and many of their new applications are fully distributed and running in containers. Now, Zeiss has customers around the world. In some countries, local regulations mandate that applications and data need to run in sovereign public clouds, as well as on-premises in some cases. So, how do companies like Zeiss comply with these requirements without having to throw away all their existing investments and build everything from scratch for these new hybrid and on-prem scenarios? The challenge Zeiss faces, it's the same set of challenges facing all modern developers. Agility, reliability, and security, even more so in the times we're living in today. Developers need to build smarter and faster. They need to move from idea to code to cloud seamlessly. Developers need new applications to be resilient in the face of failures and scale dynamically based on load. Developers need intelligent threat protection in real time with fine-grained security controls at every layer. And what makes this even harder is that developers need to solve all these problems across hybrid, edge, and multi-cloud environments. Now, as we see with customers like Zeiss, these hybrid capabilities are now critical to solving problems like data sovereignty, application modernization, and localized data processing. This is where Azure Arc comes in. With Azure and Azure Arc, we enable you to use the tools and services you're already familiar with, deploy your applications consistently to multiple clusters, automate security and governance across the entire environment, no matter where it's located. Now, this gives you tremendous flexibility, lets you deploy with high velocity, and enables you to have a single pane of glass to easily manage your entire app and data estate. Now, Azure Arc-enabled services bring the Azure services you're using today, application services, data services, ML services, to any environment. So for example, today, thousands of developers are using Azure's suite of application services, including app services, functions, logic apps. Developers love these services. They're tailored to real-world app patterns, loaded with unique features, and optimized for developer productivity. With Azure Arc, you can now run these same Azure services on premises, on the edge, and even on other clouds like AWS or GCP. When combined with the use of Arc-enabled data services like Azure Postgres and Azure SQL, which you heard about earlier today, applications and their data can now run anywhere using fully managed cloud services, an industry first. And the important thing to note is that the way you deploy does not change. You can still use your existing tools and practices and benefit from a seamless, consistent experience. Now, to show you how this works, let me hand it over to Brian, a specialist on our cloud native team.
Thanks, Gabe. Conteso Health sells medical and pharmaceutical products in retail stores all over the world. They run back-end infrastructure and store applications entirely in Azure. Customer orders come in from mobile apps, and they are sent to the appropriate store where they're fulfilled. For their application architecture, Conteso uses Azure Kubernetes Service for hosting container-based microservices, including the accounting service, which will be used later in our demos. Conteso also takes advantage of Azure PaaS services wherever possible. They host applications in Azure Web Apps and Function Apps, and data is stored in Azure SQL, Cosmos DB, and Azure Blob Storage. Conteso also uses the Distributed Application Runtime, or DAPR. DAPR provides building blocks for common challenges faced when building these microservices applications. Dapper abstracts away common tasks such as state management, secret management, messaging, and so forth, which greatly simplifies the development process. Let's take a deeper look at their core applications. This is the corporate dashboard where Conteso can see all store sales and order volume over time. This is a business-critical web application for Conteso Health. The corporate dashboard is hosted in Azure App Service. App Service is a PaaS platform that allows them to focus on their applications without having to manage VMs and infrastructure. They can manage web app security and configuration settings, auto-scale characteristics, and concepts such as deployment slots, which allow them to deploy different versions of the application to be deployed for testing and QA. Microservices are hosted in AKS, which provides a managed Kubernetes control plane for simplified hosting of their containerized workloads. As you can see, there are 8 container-based microservices that make up the back end of the application. They also have dashboards for each individual store where they can see store performance of the local sites. Store employees can see local order queue and package order items to be picked up by customers. As with any globally distributed network, outages can occur. If the Conteso retail store cannot reach Azure, they would lose the ability to process orders. To solve for this, Conteso has decided to implement Azure Stack HCI in each of their store locations. Azure Stack HCI provides various hardware form factors and delivers a platform connected to Azure that can run during loss of network connectivity. Now, normally replicating this application pattern from Azure would mean building custom solutions entirely from scratch, which is clearly unproductive and not reliable. However, with Azure Arc, Conteso can save time building out those applications at the edge using portable application and data services enabled by Azure Arc and AKS. Now each site has its own AKS cluster running locally on Azure Stack HCI with Arc as a unified control plane. Arc can manage our cluster with Azure Policy and Git Ops-based configuration management, while also bringing Azure services down to their local stores via Arc extensions. For Conteso, they now have an Azure consistent environment, making it easy to deploy their entire store platform to each site, allowing for uninterrupted operations. Here we see how they've implemented Arc extensions for one of their sites. Along with the app services and data extensions, they've implemented infrastructure solutions such as Azure Monitor, Defender, Policy, and the Open Service Mesh add-on. This allows for a consistent management experience between stores running on HCI and their other applications running in public Azure. As you can see, these extensions are bringing many of the great Azure features to Conteso's store locations via Azure Arc. Let's take a look at Azure Application Services on Kubernetes. We have a new resource called App Service Kubernetes Environment, which is hosted on their local Kubernetes cluster. There's also a custom location called Conteso Chicago. This allows them to deploy Azure web apps, function apps, and logic apps in the same way they do in the Azure public cloud. They just target the Conteso Chicago location when they deploy. Everything else is the same. Here we see how the Chicago dashboard is deployed as an Azure web app, but it is actually running in the local store's AKS cluster on Stack HCI. The management and deployment experience is the same as public Azure, including the deployment slots we saw with the corporate dashboard. The same is true with Azure Functions. Here you can see how they use a local function to process queued orders in the store. Management of these functions in Kubernetes would be the same as any other Azure function, but in this case, we've deployed it to our custom location, Conteso Chicago. Since Conteso has a large number of stores, application deployment to Kubernetes can be challenging. For this, Arc offers Git Ops-based deployments. The entire store application stack can be deployed, maintained in any Git repo, and updates are pulled into each store as code is tested and merged, making it easy to consistently deploy their applications to a large number of store locations. Later, you'll see a demo of how Conteso handles the inner-loop development and deployment process. Back to you, Gabe.
That was awesome, Brian. Now, aside from the services themselves, the second thing you want is high velocity for your deployments, while not compromising the stability of your systems. And you can achieve this combination through GitOps. Now, for those of you who are not familiar with this term, GitOps is a way of continuous deployment for cloud-native applications. Now, the core idea is having a Git repository that always contains the desired state of your infrastructure. We then pair that with an agent running in your Kubernetes clusters that ensure your workloads always match that desired state that you define in your Git repository. Now, if you want to deploy a new application or update an existing one, You just use a simple pull request to change the repository. The automated process handles everything else. Now, the cool thing about GitOps is that it helps drive strong collaboration between developers and central IT, where IT can set guardrails for governance and security configurations using GitOps, and the developers can also use GitOps for their applications. This helps drive consistency for your dev, test, and production environments. Now, let's get back to Conteso's retail application that Brian showed earlier. What if Conteso had to implement a new program quickly for their customers who shop at their branch locations? And you might think this is hard given all the components, but check this out. Let me hand it off to Lynn, a technical specialist on our cloud native team.
Thanks, Gabe. As Brian demonstrated earlier, it's easier than ever to deploy Kubernetes, app service, functions, logic apps, and API management at the edge, all while managing it through the Azure portal. Now let's talk a little bit about the app dev side of the house. As you may have noticed, the dashboards are all displayed as zero value for the average order fulfillment time. Conteso has received a number of complaints from customers that some stores are taking longer than usual to fulfill their orders. Management is asked to have that information surfaced so they can monitor and take necessary action to ensure customer satisfaction. Their front-end developer, Joey, has already made the necessary changes to the UI, and the back-end developer, yours truly, needs to make the metric available in the REST operation. I'm going to use GitHub Codespaces powered by VS Code to make this change. So here I am in the repository. If you'll notice, there's a code drop-down button here. I'm just gonna go ahead and drop this down and say open with Codespaces. I've already got a code space created, so hopefully it won't take too long to spin up. GitHub Codespaces allows developers to focus on what matters most: writing, building, and testing their code without worrying about ensuring they've got 27 different dev tools installed, 15 different Docker containers running, and whether or not it only builds and runs on their machine. Codespaces will allow them to develop wherever and whenever, even on constrained compute, as it relies on the power of Azure, GitHub, and VS Code to deliver a powerful developer experience. The Conteso code space leverages .NET 5 and Dapper, which includes Redis and Zipkin containers running in Docker. Now, the first thing we want to have a look at is the existing data the accounting service is returning, as it's the keeper of all things metric related. Let's start our Dapper sidecar since it's responsible for retrieving secrets and connection string information for us. It's also responsible for delivering order messages to the service, but we need not concern ourselves with that for now. I'm going to go ahead and bring up the command palette, go to tasks, run task. I've already created a task for the accounting service, so let's go ahead and fire that up right now. Okay, the accounting service is up and running. The next thing we want to do is start to debug the accounting controller. So let's go ahead and open up our debug view of the accounting controller. You can see here I've got a launch configuration set up for debug accounting service. Let's go ahead and kick that off. While this is starting up, I've already pre-written a REST sample for us to query the endpoint with. Let me go ahead and kick off this accounting service REST sample, which will send a request to the accounting service order metrics endpoint with a store ID of Denver. As you can see, the request is fired off. We see some SQL output generation here, and our results are returned in JSON format. Now, if you'll notice, each one of these metrics has a zero value for the average fulfillment seconds. Let's go ahead and make the changes necessary to populate that with real values. In order to do this, I'm going to open up the accounting service controller. And I already have a pretty good idea of where I need to make this code change, so we're just going to hop right to it. So we're going to add a new field that's average fulfillment time in seconds. And that's it. That should be enough to get us going. Let's go ahead and restart our debug session here. Flip back over to our REST query, and let's just make sure that we're actually getting back data that we expect. Look at that. We've already got our average fulfillment seconds filled in now. The only thing left to do at this point in time is commit our code and push it back up to our repo. In order to do that, I'm going to switch over to the source control view of Visual Studio Code. I am going to stage my changes to the accounting controller. Let me add a commit message here. Updates to accounting controller. Let's go ahead and check commit. And then let's go ahead and push our changes to our GitHub repository. Looks like those changes are pushed. So now the next thing we want to do is let's go ahead and jump over to our repo here. And if you'll notice, we've got a GitHub action set up that's going to go ahead and do a number of things for us. The first thing it's going to do is it's going to build the accounting controller. Next, it's going to create a Docker image that's tagged with the short SHA of the GitHub commit itself. It's then going to take that Docker image, push it to a GitHub container registry, and finally, it's going to update the Kubernetes manifest for the deployment service so that our GitOps processes can pick them up and update the appropriate deployments. Now, Conteso chose to use a GitOps process instead of the typical deployment pipeline because it has hundreds, if not thousands, of stores that need to update these changes locally. In a typical deployment pipeline, you would end up having to push those changes individually to every single store. With a GitOps approach, it flips that on its head, and instead, we basically install an operator in your Kubernetes cluster that's constantly searching for changes that are occurring in this GitHub repository. If it locates a change that needs to be applied, it will go ahead and do a rolling update of that deployment. Hence, all of the replicas will then update their images, and lo and behold, we'll have new code up and running in the cluster. So it looks like this is complete now. So let's just go ahead and click into it. Everything looks great. Let's go ahead and flip back over to our Denver store. You can still see here that we've got a fulfillment time of 0 seconds, and that's okay. What's happening is the operator that's running in the cluster only polls every 5 minutes or so to see if there's any changes, but we can go ahead and prod it along if we want. I've got a command prompt window pulled up here that shows all of our pods that are currently running. The one that we're interested in is the accounting service pod. Notice it's been up for about 43 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and issue a command to tell the GitOps operator to go ahead and refresh itself now rather than waiting for the scheduled time interval. What we should see here in just a second is it will have reached out to our GitHub repository, as you can see now. It has downloaded the new manifest. It's downloaded a new container image. It's now doing a rolling upgrade to the deployment. So if you'll notice, we haven't pulled down the original version of the accounting service yet because the new one isn't quite ready. Notice there's two containers in this pod, and only one of two of them is ready at this point in time. Again, remember, one of those is our accounting service business logic itself, and the other one is our Dapper container. Now notice they've both come up two of two. The old accounting service is terminating, and look here, we're now getting results in our fulfillment time, 39 seconds. That's pretty impressive. So hopefully this has given you a quick glimpse into what's possible from a developer perspective with Codespaces, Azure Arc, and GitOps. Back to you, Gabe.
That was awesome to see how quickly Lynn was able to deploy a new application in seconds at an edge location with the same cloud native experiences and tools that he's already familiar with. And now finally, to round out your developer experience, you get a modern management experience through Azure Arc for all of your applications, no matter where or how they are deployed. And we bring this to you through something called extensions. You can now turn on additional Azure integrated services like security and monitoring services for your Arc-enabled Kubernetes clusters right in the Azure portal or CLI. And you only pay for what you use. Extensions greatly simplify onboarding. Customers can deploy Azure integrations with just a few clicks or API calls. Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes ensures you always have the latest bits and can automatically apply updates as soon as they become available. Now, one such capability that is available for you is Azure Monitor for Containers. With this, you can monitor the performance of your container workloads deployed in the cloud on AKS, as well as on any Arc-enabled Kubernetes cluster, all directly in the Azure portal. This enables a single pane of glass view so that developers and operations teams can really track what's happening across their environments in a single view. You can expect more innovation in this space, and we are super excited to see what you all build with this technology.